bought a Rose Rush, cause bitch, I want my roses today. Y'all been hiding from the truth, but y'all gon' listen today. I'm the head coach, so know what position to play. Gas bag, shout it, yeah, I gotta fly to the bay. Knock the lead out your rib, I got tape on the K. She a goddess of the trap, angel white like EA. She so motherfucking thick, you never know where you stay. Like a cartoon, a bitch took a pot to the face. Ice cube, cold game, it's one hell of a day. She got a real pretty face, you like, where's her waist? Took the bitch to the place and she like, where's the safe? Looking in my pockets, it's filled with blue honeys. Don't let them move me, but they got damn money. Drop a bag, make the room clear, run, run, dear. They stick long as a broom, it can kill a reindeer. Before you came here, we were selling cane here. Since Gucci Mane left, it just not the same here. And I make a false jump, cause he yelling, help, help. With him up like Mike Bell, didn't see Bell. Came in with the trap, cut, better not Welch. He brought it on his own self, he cost his own death. Tryna make a death threat with a weak rail. Uphill battle, running up some steep stairs. Ballers on the right, haters on the left. Money make these bitches can't keep their hands to themselves. Where this money coming in, shit, I'ma need some help. East Atlanta Center, and y'all all Center L's. Breaking just a pretty nigga, I was just 12. You still ain't get no screening, nigga, you just took a L. If I do a feature, it's gon' cost like 50 bills. I need an endorsement on the poster boy for scales. Took a million risks, I took the train, I took the mail. Most you niggas shell, I sell water to a well. Tried to put me in a cell, I'm too strong, I still prevail. Smoke one for a Leah, nigga, turn this up a lil. Looking in my pockets, it's filled with blue honey.
Don't move me, but money.
A broom, it can kill a
reindeer.
Before you came here, we were selling cane here. Since Gucci Mane left, it's just not the same here. And I make a false deal, cause he yelling.
Yep, help.
With him up like Mike Bell, did a
seatbelt. Ay, 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 ay. Ba 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 ba. I do not own the rights to that beat. So gon' be, so I can't have a song gon' repeat. I'm already getting copyrighted, and I don't want allegations, I can't fight it. I'm all off beat, y'all know. It's Friday, uh-oh, yeah. What's up, y'all? I was all off beat. I had the words, but they just never come out right anymore. Listen, man. That Gucci Mane, that Gucci Mane clone, I wasn't feeling them, but I do like that song. Don't nothing move me but the money. Oh, haters to the right, haters to the left, ballers to the right. Oh, I like that song. I still feel like Gucci Mane's a clone, but like I said, I don't own rights to that music, but YouTube, y'all gonna copyright me anyway, so... You know, anyway, let's get in. First of all, what did I do today? Nothing much. Worked out, worked hard, got sweaty. You know, it's Friday and they made me do work and it wasn't cool, but you know, don't nothing move me but the money. They said you got to move, so I was like, okay, so it's only right to open up with that song because, you know, they make me earn my money today, y'all. I've been watching Shogun, which is this show on FX about some samurais and stuff, and I was telling my husband, I think it's so funny, like, in Asian, old school films and shows where they, like, say something and then they do that laugh where they don't show their teeth or nothing, and it's like, and I like that. They'll be like, I don't know why, it just tickles me so much. When they do that laugh, it's like, you know, that was really funny, but I'm not going to bust the gut, but it was funny. I think I'm going to start laughing like that. It's kind of cool. Anyway, yeah, that's all I did today, y'all. Watch a bunch of TV and just wait for this week to be over, like I'm sure everybody else does every weekend. Oh, adulting is so hard.
But I wouldn't go back to being a kid, so there's that. I would go back to having my young bones and joints and muscles that I had as a kid, but I wouldn't go back to my childhood. Anyway, yeah, let's get into the news. So, Los Angeles police investigate a 30 million Easter heist. I have a video of that. Hey, if you're gonna do a heist, that's how you do it, baby. They robbed Gardeworld. And I do not condone crime, but if you gonna do some time, baby, you better do it right, okay? That was a heist, okay? I ain't seen one in a while. This is like better than TV. We'll get into that. A judge denies Trump's motion to dismiss documents case. Video shows Tyson's trainer wincing and spitting fluid after absorbing punches from Iron Mike. I wouldn't want to be his trainer. Still waiting on the ceasefire in Israel. Biden is pressing Netanyahu to cease fire. Haitians seek to flee gang-fueled anarchy as neighbors boost militaries. Hopefully, people are taking in the Haitians. I know a lot of people are trying to get up out of there. FAA is investigating a close call between a plane at LaGuardia's air traffic control tower. WWE star Chelsea Green claims New York City hotel staff thought she was an escort and kicked her out. Did she show up in her, like, wrestling outfit or something? So we got the bird flu on the rise, y'all. Everybody's saying you better make sure your eggs is done because they send this back. You got the bird flu. I was just telling my husband, I was like, man, I wouldn't mind going to Chicago for some food. And then I seen the measles and the tuberculosis is coming up there. I mean, it's just about time to stay in the house again, which I already do, but you know. Rescue teams in Taiwan have airlifted 928 pounds of food to the mining area where 64 people remain trapped. Hopefully, they get out soon. All right, let's go over to X, see what is popping over there. X was crazy today, y'all. I ain't gonna lie, I got a lot of crap. Germany is wants to ban elephant trophies. Botswana is threatening to send 20,000 elephants in response. Justin, this is Justin. Sean Diddy Combs, who's subject to federal sex trafficking, is named as a defendant in a new lawsuit that alleges his son sexually assaulted a woman while she was working on a yacht in the music mogul's chartered trip. I hope that saying ain't so, young Diddy. Saying ain't so. One person was killed and two others hospitalized Thursday when a section of a crane fell. I got that video too. That's crazy. Number one seed UConn is scheduled to play four-seeded Alabama on Saturday night. Yeah, here's that crane. That's crazy, y'all. Freaking crane just fell. Those are those kind of freak accidents that you do not want to die in. Like, how did that happen? New Netflix series Ripley follows a queer-coded killer and master manipulator, Tom Ripley. I was about to start trying to watch that. I don't know. How many times can we redo this story? Like, is there anything else that we can make a story about? A trip to Crown Reef Beach Resort and Water Park in South Carolina abruptly turned to horror when a family's youngest child drowned in a resort pool. At least three children fatally drowned at the resort between 2018 and 2021. Lawsuits show. It's like they need a lifeguard. A truck overturned in Oregon spilled over 100,000 live salmon, most of the which landed in a creek. Okay. So y'all creek gonna have some salmon in it. Fresh salmon. Y'all better be out there catching it. That's free food. I bet you they'll try to recapture it. But hear me out, when them salmon get in there and mate with the catfish or whatever, it's on and on. Gonna be a whole new fish. All right, you guys get your solar eclipse glasses. I don't plan on looking at it. I've never ever saw a solar eclipse except for when y'all record them. I just don't care enough. Just don't. All right, let me get into some stuff I liked on this crazy, crazy app. So, popular Band-Aids have cancer-causing materials that can travel through the open wounds. Environmental health watchdogs had 40 bandages from 18 different brands tested for fluorine. So that Band-Aids is, So here's this.
News at 11, millions and millions of dollars in cash missing. The LAPD and FBI now investigating a huge SoCal heist that happened over the Easter weekend. Eyewitness News has learned those missing millions were taken from a cash vault and armored car facility in Sylmar. Air 7HD even spotting what appears to be a large boarded-up hole on the side of that vault building. Eyewitness News reporter Michelle Fisher live in Sylmar tonight with new details on what's believed to be one of the biggest thefts in LA history. Michelle.
Mark, it's like something that you'd see in a Hollywood movie, but that multi-million dollar mystery playing out at a facility here in Sylmar, the sophisticated heist leading authorities to believe a crew of some kind is behind this brazen break-in. The Garda World facility in Sylmar tonight at the center of a joint FBI and LAPD investigation, days after thieves broke in and stole tens of millions of dollars on Easter. Officials briefed on the investigation telling ABC News the thieves got in undetected without setting off alarms through the roof. This Air 7 video showing the building's roof hatch and also a boarded up hole and pile of debris on the side of the facility. It's unclear if that damage is related to Sunday's theft and just how much money was taken from Garda World. But the heist comes almost 2 years after an estimated $100 million in jewelry was stolen from a Brinks transport semi parked at a truck stop on Interstate 5 near Fraser Park.
But the seal is broken, and that's clearly fresh cut, and there's clearly fresh work mark right there. There's fresh work dust.
And to this day, that case from 2022 remains unsolved. As for this heist here, authorities telling ABC News that right now there are no suspects. A lot of unanswered questions still. If you have any information, of course, please contact police.
A good old-fashioned bank heist. See, y'all people that stealing cell phones and stuff, no, this is the money right here. Big bank heist. I mean, shoot, man. I do not condone crime, but I'm just saying, it's interesting. It's better than TV. So, you know how I say I'm clumsy and I have calamity? Look at this poor guy. Dropped the weight on his phone and literally the phone caught on fire. That's something that would happen to me. Alright, we saw the crane video. So this YouTuber did crack for 30 days to prove that drug addiction isn't real, and now he's a crackhead. Um Yeah, I'm looking at this though. It says this is a fake video. He never was a guest on Joe Rogan. He has superimposed himself over video to give the impression that Joe Rogan is reacting to what he's saying. So that was fake. This is crazy. This dude was coming out of his house and his intuition just knew he was about to get robbed. Wow. Could you imagine living there? Like, every time you come out your door, dude, you gotta be ready to pop somebody. That's almost how I feel in my neighborhood, for real. That's why I'm moving. This dude got the ultimate plot twist. He's acting like he's on a Zoom call, but he's driving with a green screen in the back. Like, that's some dedication, but my guy, did you have to go somewhere that bad? Like, you could totally wreck. So yeah, Chicago has a tuberculosis outbreak in the migrant shelter and confirmed 55 cases of measles as well.
This comes after 56 known measles cases are reported in the Windy City. Chicago Alderman Raymond Lopez has warned about this issue for months, and he joins us now. So Raymond, you warned them that this was gonna happen, but they didn't listen to you. Are they listening now?
You know, Lawrence, good morning. I don't know how much our Department of Public Health or other officials are listening to the alarms that we've been raising since August of last year, and even in September when we had receipts from our ambulances showing that we had individuals testing positive for tuberculosis. This is a crisis we could have avoided, just like with the measles, if we had simply instituted the American standard of vaccines upon all of those migrants being shipped to the city of Chicago. Many of these individuals come with children, they are in our schools, and all of those vaccination requirements that our kids are responsible for are waived for the migrant asylum seeker children. And that is putting people, families, and communities at risk.
You know, Raymond, I've been so perplexed because, you know, I've been out there reporting, talking with the folks. They're upset. I know your district. And the people there are minorities. They're also, you got immigrants there as well. But it seems like the mayor has tried to paint those that are critical of the sanctuary city policy and not having a response to the people there as anti-immigrant.
Without question, we have seen where efforts by this administration to put migrants on a toxic dump site were labeled as racist when people like myself and community opposed it, saying it wasn't healthy for them or for the neighborhood to have all of that dust kicked up. Even when I brought this issue about tuberculosis, measles, and mumps to the forefront, I've been told that I'm anti-immigrant and xenophobic, even though I'm the great-grandson of immigrants. So they could gaslight all they want, but at a certain point, the truth is going to come out, and we're seeing it come out slowly and steadily now, as we saw with the measles and as we're seeing now with tuberculosis.
Real quickly, because I only got 15 seconds, Raymond, do you think people in Chicago, because of this issue, because I haven't seen people at these city council meetings like this in a long time, do you think they're going to start voting differently just based on this issue alone?
Well, as you mentioned earlier, Americans are fed up with seeing themselves being leapfrogged over by those coming to this country just to get service and support. And I think that at some point, this is going to drive a wedge, particularly for the Democratic Party, my party, with our core base of African American and Latino voters who feel as though we have not invested in them the way we're investing in these migrant asylum seekers.
Such a valid point. A man of the...
Man, I would not want to be the mayor of Chicago. The last mayor couldn't get it done, and it looks like this one is failing. Look, check out this crazy cartoon, y'all.
Be a monster and hold girls against their will, chain them up in my basement, and don't let them eat, and don't let them out.
I hope tired her.
Quit playing.
And I want to just tell you how proud I am of you. Sometimes you have to really go with that decision in your gut. And in my gut, I was like, you need to get on the plane. And God told me,
it's time.
And we needed to have a story that had a happy ending.
So they actually got a tape of Diddy busting up Meek Mill. Bro, you gotta be playing. Man, Puffy the real Buddha warrior, dog.
They actually taped it.
Meek Mill's
is like Puffy.
Man, this shit is getting wild. Is we really going to the Caribbeans to help Didi though?
Don't f with him. I don't give a f about him. Period.
So you really going way out there to turn him in? Man, you the pettiest nigga alive, feel
I'm not petty. Nah, I'm a sophisticated petty.
Man, I appreciate you for letting me smoke this gas on the J2 family. You wanna hit this? No Didi.
I'm high as a motherfucker and I ain't even smoking this shit.
Dream chasers, nigga. I hope they forgive me for what I did with Didi. Real street nigga forever.
Your God is good. I changed my name to Love. Love is my real name. That's what it says on my driver's license. That's my official name, Love.
Take that, take that.
There go Brother Love and Usher right there.
Sean Diddy Combs, you need to come with us. You're under arrest for sex trafficking.
Take that.
They done made a cartoon. They making documentaries. They making everything, y'all. It's just crazy. All right, let's see what TMZ's talking about. Angelina Jolie claims Brad Pitt abused her pre-26 plane incident. She's floating new allegations against Brad Pitt, claiming he roughed her up before the plane incident that ended their marriage, but we're hearing a different story. In court documents obtained by TMZ, Angie's attorney levied a heavy accusation against her ex, namely that he'd allegedly physically abused her before their incident in the sky in 2016, which Angelina has maintained involved Brad putting his hands on their kid. We know Brad's denied that and that authorities cleared him of wrongdoing, but Angelina has continued to insist it happened, including here where her attorney says the abuse AJ claims to have endured via Brad Pitt predated 2016. They write, while Pitt's history of physical abuse of Jolie started well before the family's September 2016 plane trip from France to Los Angeles, this flight marked the first time he turned physical on the children, and Jolie immediately left him. Angelina and her team do not detail what allegedly occurred, but they're certainly hinting that there is more to tell from her side. The reason this is even coming up right now is because Angelina has filed a motion in the ongoing winery case that Angie and Brad are still involved in, with BP suing Angie for trying to sell her shares of the winery in their chateau to a third party. Well, her team filed this week, if granted, would force Brad's camp to fork over communications with Angie's team, believes will help sell their argument that Brad allegedly refused to sell her winery shares without a signing reworked NDA. Mm-hmm. Angelina's lawyers say they believe Brad has been trying to muzzle Angelina further by having her sign a more expansive and meticulous NDA in what they claim is an effort to stop her from leaking any info that might be damaging to Brad. Her team claims she was down to sign a standard NDA in her original offer to sell him her shares, but claims he backpedaled and wanted it tightened up amid their custody dispute. As for Brad's side, we're hearing the exact opposite from everything she's claiming. Someone close to Brad tells us that Angelina is doing this par for course, in which a decision doesn't go her way. She puts out false and misleading info like this to change the narrative and confuse the public, especially for a case like this playing out. We're told Brad knows the claim she's making. Don't hold any water because they've already litigated this in court. And listen, I didn't even know they still fighting over stuff. Fighting over chateaus and a lot of rich people problems going on here, man. But Brad, he ain't backing down. He's like, no, you ain't getting it. Kanye's wife is brawless again. Not shocking. Diddy's daughters are vacationing with LeBron's son. LeBron is catching all kind of strays from this Diddy stuff. Just from him hanging out with them, it's like people really hate LeBron. It's just so sad. Britney Spears is posting throwback videos of her and her ex. She's missing him. So this guy, Rip Michaels, I forget what they said he did. He was on Wild and Out. He's a comedian. He said his wife left him to die when he was in a hospital. He's only got 17% of his heart, but he is recovering. But he said his wife burned out on him. when he was down and out. I don't know what's up with that, but you know, hopefully he recovers. Alright, I think that might be it on this one. Let's see if there's anything else worth reading. Yeah, ain't nothing there, so let's try some Reddits. So glad it's Friday, y'all. I don't know why every time I come to this site, this stupid thing is stuck. Like, what's up with you, bro? Jabroni. What's one thing you will always carry with you no matter what, even if it's not your basic survival or necessity? I need water and Carmex. Those are the things I need in life. I can't go far without them too. I wouldn't mind some gum too. Somebody said my cat put a deflated balloon in my backpack like a year ago. It's still in there. I don't need it for anything, but I think it's cute. My late husband's wedding ring is on a rope around my neck. A single acorn in my pocket. One of my father's old handkerchiefs. Lip balm. See, this is practical for me. I don't have no good luck charms or nothing, but I carry the Lord with me everywhere I go. Amen. What's something your parents told you as a kid that you now realize was entirely not true? Shoot, man. My dad told me Baskin Robbins was only open on the 31st. That it's illegal to drive with the light in a car. I think everybody kind of went with that myth. I don't know if it was a lie that parents intentionally, I think everybody believed that. My mom told us that if we ever had two or more pieces of Twizzler, we would have unbearable diarrhea. So it might be true for some people. Be quiet on a boat, you'll scare the fish away. My dad just wanted us to be quiet. I don't know. Is that a myth? Because a lot of fishermen believe if you're too loud, it's not good. My brother fully believed for 26 years that my mother's middle name was Ermitrude. So she lied. Everything will work out if you're willing to put in the hard work. I mean, they just believe that. I guess you have to almost believe it, right? Even though, you know, it's 50-50. You kind of have to have that glass half full mentality. Get a degree, you'll be set for life. They had, once again, they had hope in that. Much as I love this song, if I start hearing some music in the background, I will not pay attention. Alright, what do you wish you can experience again for the first time? Like, when you first try some really good food, like, you never get that feeling again once it's never the same. Listening to my favorite album for the first time. The first time I went to the ocean, too. Even though every time I go to the ocean, I have the same kind of feeling. It's just something about when you see it for the first time. My first pair of glasses, hugging my grandpa. I wish I could fall in love with my husband again. Meeting my dog at the shelter. First kiss. watching Lord of the Rings, raising my kids. I wouldn't go back to raising my kids, but I do miss, like, dressing them up in their Halloween costumes for the first time. So fun and cute. And their first, you know, their first, like, chuckles. I love babies' laughter. The best. Alright, I'll read a couple of Am I the A-Holes because I do have some story times that I gotta play for y'all. Am I the a-hole for calling my dad a creep and banning him from my birthday party after I caught him with one of my best friends? So I'm 19 and I came home from school Friday because my mom was throwing me a party on Saturday. I was planning on staying at my dad's house while I was in town, and I got out of class early, and so I got out of his house about an hour and 30 minutes earlier than planned. I'm guessing he wasn't expecting me that early because I walked in on him and one of my best friends, Tyler, who's a dude as well, on the couch going at it. To say that I was sick to my stomach is an understatement. Now, I wasn't surprised that he was with a guy I knew my dad was by, but him with one of my friends was just, yeah. They freaked out and scrambled to put on clothes, and I'm just like, what the... Tyler tried to explain how they had saw each other on Grindr over the summer, and it wasn't supposed to have become this whole thing. I just yelled at him to get out, and he practically ran out of the house. My dad just kind of standing there embarrassed. I'm just like, what are you thinking? Tyler's been one of my best friends since the sixth grade. That he used to monitor our sleepovers and coach our baseball team. He gets mad and says that they're both adults and it's none of my business. I call him a creep and an effing weirdo, and I tell him I don't want him at my birthday party and to not bother showing up. I guess he told my mom and she thinks that I was harsh. Your mama chirping. No, you're not the a-hole. The birthday party, I'd be probably banning him from a lot more. Probably be falling out with the baseball team and didn't see if he did anything strange. That's kind of, to date somebody you knew as a child is and will always be weird for me, whether you're gay or not. It's just weird. It's just extremely strange. So no, you're definitely not the a-hole. Not the a-hole, super creepy. I don't understand how a parent can look at a person they watched grow up. Yeah, same thing I just said. Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy. What the heck? What's up with these dads being pedos today? Am I the a-hole for calling my dad a pedophile? I'm 15 and my dad's 38, just dropped a huge bomb. He says he's dating the daughter, 16, of his friend, who's 38, a friend he used to date. She isn't very happy about it, and neither are their mutual friends. He vented about it to me, saying they're being unfair to him. I just said, what did you expect, Jacob Black? Mom made both of us watch the movie with her back when they were together, so he got the reference. As we went on about how he did nothing wrong and told me he is going to give him a piece of his mind, I told him most people wouldn't listen to him because he's a pedo. That was when he snapped at me. He quickly got in my face and said that it's pedophilia if the girl is prepubescent, but this girl is already 16 and that I shouldn't slander him. The a-hole asked him his thoughts on a 38-year-old man who wanted to date his own 16-year-old daughter. What does a nearly 40-year-old man have in common with a 16-year-old? I'd be telling everyone that didn't run fast enough that he's into children. He's old enough to be her parent. Yeah, that's some crazy. This is some crazy stuff today, y'all. All right, let's get into these story times.
ain't changed a bit.
Oh!
I thought I saw you. I just got through surgery.
Heart transplant. They were on life support, but, you know, I had to bring her back to life. I had to check her temperature. I had to put my telescope to work.
Doing your work on coochies, doctor.
Well, if you're talking about a gynecologist, I got biology in my gynecology. Well, you're gonna start something you can't finish. I still got nightmares. When you left me. How's that, what's the nigga name?
Shit.
What's the nigga you married? The nigga you
nigga,
left me for. What is the nigga name?
Charles.
Your husband, right?
Charles. Something like that.
Something like that?
Yeah.
What's that? Talk to him. You know, I'm a doctor. I can solve any puzzle.
Ouch. I'm feeling a little pain in my left titty. I was gonna see, can I come up to your office and let you...
Your lip notes?
It's my lip notes. Still a lip. Mm.
Let me check your temperature. Let me check your temperature.
Check this.
Let me check your temperature. Right there. Check your temperature. Mm-hmm. I can put you in my book. Oh. Give you a CAT scan, and I can scan the cat. That's right. That was a double entendre, but here's my card. Oh. Call me.
Okay.
If you need someone to, you know, talk to. Okay. Call me. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call me. If you need someone to talk to, call me. I still got the...
So that's a reenactment for the show BMF, and this is almost better than the show, because there is a scene in there with the wife is flirting with this guy she's a date, but that was a funny reenactment.
So has anybody else figured this out? That this April, we have 10 days in a row that are palindrome days, basically meaning you read the date from front to back or from back to front, it's the same exact numbers. 10 days in a row. Has this ever happened before? Like, this is crazy. And we have a total solar eclipse happening this month. Yeah. This April is wild. This April is wild. And it starts on 420. This is crazy. This is crazy. I want to know. I don't even know. Like, I have to look this up. So have we ever had this many dates, like palindrome dates, in one month? And these are like all back to back from 420 to 429 this year. All the dates are palindrome dates. So if you read it from the beginning, from front to back, and then turn around and read it from back to front, it's the same dates. It's the same thing. The same number pattern. That's crazy. That's crazy. Does this mean something? Where are my conspiracy theory people at? I need to know. Like, I need to know. Has anybody else picked up on this? Because this is blowing my mind.
Supposedly, alignment is upon us. Palindrome.
Let's be fresh. Hold on, hold on. You want to be fresh? No. Don't tell me what the fuck I'm gonna do. Let's be rational. We are in a fucking tin can with a baby in a goddamn echo chamber, and you want to talk to me about being fucking okay?
Okay, because you're yelling.
So is the baby.
Okay, so you're a man.
Did that motherfucker pay extra to you?
Okay, no.
Fuck you and shut up. I don't give a fuck. You were sitting there watching that motherfucking baby cry for 45 something minutes. This shit didn't have nothing to do with nothing.
Or your voice.
Fuck blowing that baby's voice.
He's an asshole.
No, okay.
He's a grown ass man.
It's all good. What happened? I'm sorry, y'all.
Fuck that.
I'm sorry.
I'm tripping. Fuck that
baby.
That man was sick of that baby. He was sick of that baby crying. I mean, he definitely was overreacting, but I ain't gonna lie, man. I don't want to hear no baby crying my whole flight. I mean, People are just annoyed on planes. I mean, you want to give a baby a pass on a plane, but it's just flying with a child. I mean, I feel the brother. I can't be mad at him. I mean, was his delivery terrible? Absolutely. But he was just, I don't know. I got to give, why was he, how he said the baby was crying for a long time. I don't know what was going on, but yeah, the worst thing that can happen is when you see a baby on a plane.
Okay, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I love you.
Right, what's your question, Mama?
All right, my question is, I'm dealing with my daughter. I have guardianship of her two babies. She's a little bit different.
When you say different, how different we talking?
Evil.
Oh, Lord Jesus. You raised them now. Hold up now.
Well, yes, I did. But this the baby. And she always trying to beat me up, threaten me, you know. But I'm not going to give up on her. I'm going to keep the babies until she get them back. We almost in the last stages. My question is, should I just stop? Should I just give up and try to preserve what little bit of relationship that we have? Because I think once she gets the kids back, she's not going to let me see my grandbabies. And the judge told her she wasn't allowed to leave the babies unattended. And on the same day the judge told her, she just didn't come back and get the kids.
She ain't smoking that shit, is she?
No, she not. Okay. I think she went to party.
How long you done had the kids?
My daughter had them for a year, and I have them for maybe about 3 months now.
You're tired. You're tired.
I'm tired of her BS. I'm not tired of the kid. I'm tired of having to go through the emotional thing with her. But we're almost there.
If I asked your other kids, would they say that you put a lot of favoritism on this baby daughter of yours?
No, I didn't.
My mama would say the same thing, too, about my baby sister, right? Y'all coddling these kids, and you probably was a lot lighter on her than you did your other kids.
I was.
See, there we go. We getting somewhere. And I can tell right now that you just got so much hope for her. And you want her to be there for her children, but you know, you didn't leave your kids nowhere unattended. That ain't love. You coddling her. And that's why she's sorry now, because guess what? You've always backed her up, and you backing her up now. She ain't coming to get them damn kids. You got them. I'm sorry. You can't give them away. They children. It ain't like it's a dog. They right. Kids. You their grandmama. You enabling her behavior, and you probably always have, and I guarantee if I asked your other children, they would say that you raised her like this. Go ahead, keep them kids and just have them call you Meemaw.
They call me My.
Okay. How old are they?
Bella is 5 and Azai is 1. He'll be 2 in February.
See, and them babies too young to even be going through that instability right there. So, like, I would just be telling them, if you get them children back, do you know 100% of your heart that your daughter is going to be there for them kids and not put them in a dangerous situation? Will you be able to sleep at night?
I will, because this lesson is hard for her. She's going through it too, because she just had another little baby, a Yulani. She's 1. She's what? Not even just a month.
So yeah. She got 3 children?
Yes.
I'm going to be honest with you. This is you got to eat this one. This is your fault. Because you even still taking off for right now. You need to whoop her ass right now. And this starts now.
Okay. She a big one. She's 6'2". I'm going to have to hit her with something.
You ain't going to physically whoop her ass. You're going to emotionally whoop her ass.
Okay,
you
ain't got no business.
Hey, if she put hands on you, she going to have to deal with me. Because ain't nobody going to be disrespecting their mama, Ryan. I'm sorry. That's your mama. Your big ass wouldn't be if it wasn't for her.
That part.
All right, why not?
Tasha actually gave some good advice. Sometimes she's not always messy.
Hey, y'all. It's your girl, Millie Chun, and I am here with Brianna Branch. Have you heard about Brianna Branch? She kind of that girl. Not in a good way, but that girl. So this is Brianna and her husband, Denzel Branch. And he is a minister. They live in Oak Cliff, I believe, Texas. And she has supported him through his whole ride in his ministry lane. She's right here behind him as he is getting his licensing of ministry. She got his back. You know what I'm saying? is his wife. But then every once in a while, something else comes along. So enters Joshua Andrews. He is clearly the organ player in the church. Well, Joshua and Brianna took a liking to each other. And it went so far as to the point where on Easter Sunday, this past Easter Sunday, they was like, forget it. We about to dress alike. I said all that to say this. Joshua, the organ player for the church, unallowed the youth pastor, Denzel, Brianna's husband. The Dallas authorities responded in Oak Cliff. The preliminary investigation determined 30-year-old man Joshua Andrews and a male victim, that would be Denzel, was involved in an argument, which ended up unaliving him. The victim, identified as 31-year-old Denzel Branch, was taken to a local hospital where he passed away from his injuries. Y'all, hold on. So this was at a Kojic church, right, on Easter Sunday. Now, to get all into it, the meat and potatoes of it, Joshua Bell, who is the organist, he was adopted by Christopher Andrews. He's the brother of the pastor, Superintendent Eric Andrews. I'm just giving you that. Joshua is the church organist who unalived the youth pastor, Denzel LeVar Branch. So these two men, Denzel and Joshua, have been into it for some time. 4 days ago, the two men had a bad tussle and said that Denzel put a whipping on Joshua. Joshua could not with that. So according to somebody who was at church on Easter Sunday, they said that the two men had shouted and danced all during the service, right? And it said that Joshua, the organist, wore a pink suit. He then went and changed into his white suit so he and Brianna could be matching. So after that, I guess it was Brianna's idea to let's take some photos. So the two were taking pictures and interrupted by Denzel and said, I know you're not going to do this here. Joshua, the organist, tells the pastor, yeah, we're doing it. And he was very sarcastic with it. And it escalated and it ended up with the organist, Joshua, unaliving the pastor, Denzel. Now here we have three the hard way, right? So we got over here Denzel, who's no longer with us, Brianna, who's without mans, and he should be going to jail for life because the fact that he couldn't handle that tussle that Denzel put on him, he unalived him, that made no sense. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this and what y'all doing down there at Oak Cliff.
That is the craziest story. It makes no sense to me. I mean, if you saw this man, you would think he played for the other team. Like, I thought it was going to be a love triangle story, not this whole, something ain't right. If I was a betting person, I would say that it's something deeper to this story than they fighting over dress. And why would the wife dress like him when her husband just got into a fight with him the day before? Strange.
Tonight we're learning a custody dispute may be at the center of a bizarre missing persons case in the Midwest. Two moms from Kansas seemingly dropped off the face of the earth, leaving no clues or answers behind except for an abandoned car. Veronica Butler and Jillian Kelly were last seen Saturday. Butler's family says the two friends were traveling together to Oklahoma to pick up Butler's kids. Police found their car empty in a rural part of Oklahoma near a school where Butler graduated from in 2015. Today, that school operated on lockdown for the second day in a row. News Nation correspondent Brooke Schaefer joins us live from Hugotown, Kansas, where the two women are actually from. Brooke, what are you learning? Have we heard anything from the women's families?
The families and investigators, I can tell you, Elizabeth, so far staying pretty tight-lipped tonight. No word, really, on where these two missing moms could be. And the town where they live here, Hugoton, Kansas, very much on edge tonight. Like you mentioned, a school near the area where that abandoned car was found, operating on lockdown mode for a second day in a row. Doors stayed locked. Visitors were limited to the school today. Family and friends say the two women were on their way to pick up Veronica Butler's two children when they seemingly vanished. Again, the car that they were in found abandoned on the side of the road. The children they were picking up were Veronica Butler's two kids, kids that she shares with an ex, and kids who right now are under the custody of the paternal grandmother. From what we've been told, it seems like there is some serious bad blood between Veronica Butler and her ex's mother. When the two women didn't come back to Hugoton, Kansas with those kids, I'm told Butler's new husband went looking for them, and people in town say it's Veronica Butler's husband who found the car abandoned on the side of the road. The two moms, I'm told, more acquaintances than friends, but very involved in their community and their churches. Butler's small business here in Hugoton, Kansas, closed until further notice as investigators work to find these two moms. A woman here in town telling me she is very concerned, especially with little to no updates from authorities. Elizabeth?
Yeah, absence of information does little to reassure people who might be on edge. Brooke Schaefer, yeah. Thanks so much for that live report. Let's bring in Jennifer Coffendapper, former FBI agent and News Nation law and justice contributor. Jennifer, first of all, why would this high school be on lockdown?
Well, that's really concerning. Anytime you lock down a school like that is because you feel like there might be a threat in terms of if you are law enforcement toward individuals in that school. And I think that's very concerning. What sort of threat do they think exists for people in that school? I guess it's because of the nexus with Veronica, but it's certainly concerning.
Yeah, especially if it is a custody dispute of some kind. Do we know where these kids are, how old they are, anything about them? I mean, are they students perhaps at that school?
It's been very tight-lipped, but I would believe they might be students at that school. It makes sense from the proximity. We know it's a very small school. In fact, Veronica was the first and only person to graduate in 2015. So it's a teeny, teeny school, so it makes sense the children might go there, and perhaps they're concerned about a threat toward the children.
I imagine in all these cases, family members of the missing women are the first people police focus on, especially given the fact that it was many years ago in 2015, but there was a big, very bitter custody dispute in 2015 between Veronica Butler and her ex.
Absolutely. Anytime I hear and law enforcement hears that there's a custody dispute, you automatically hone in on that because of all the cases that have occurred where custody was at the neck.
Well, we'll just follow this. It's a weird story. Very strange.
Today in Springfield, Missouri, this school bus was on its way to drop off 13 kids at a middle school when a sex offender pries open the school bus doors and tries to get off. As you could probably see from that video, the kids went to the back of the bus and got out the emergency exit there, ran to neighbors' homes who were able to keep them there until their parents came to pick them up or a different bus took them to school. But that suspect took the keys from the bus driver. Thankfully, none of the students, the bus driver, were not injured. The suspect then ran into his house and stayed there for about 8 hours. So it was an 8-hour long standoff with police today. That suspect has now been taken into custody, but there are a lot of questions asking. He has prior convictions. He is a registered sex offender, a non-compliant sex offender, and has previous convictions for kidnapping and other charges that put him on the sex offender registry. So in the coming days, a lot of questions I would imagine will be asked about how this person was, free and not in, jail or prison or some sort of mental health institution.
Well, those kids are super smart to go out the back. Thank goodness they did do that. That's crazy.
The U.S. is about to be overrun with cicadas. Over 100 trillion cicadas are about to emerge all at the same time. And it's going to happen shortly after the solar eclipse on April 8th. The last time something like this happened was back in 1803. This is happening because two different generations of cicadas have matched up their timing. One species emerges every 13 years and the other every 17 years. These are both prime numbers, so they only match up every 221 years. If you live in the Midwest, maybe invest in some hearing protection because it's going to get very, very loud.
I mean, I grew up with cicadas and then they disappeared and now they're back. I don't know. I don't know what to say. I am just going to laugh like the people in the samurai movie. I will be back. I will be back. You enjoy your weekend. You enjoy your weekend. I don't know what voice I'm doing right now, but I do know that it's the weekend, baby. You guys have fun. I'll be praying for you. Let your hair down, relax, and don't worry about nothing that happened this last week. And yeah, get ready. Get ready for those cicadas.